Good morning everyone. Today I will tell you how to get correlation matrix for the features. So here we are having various features: AM, median, summation, variance, standard deviation, and all these things, right? SKW is the skewness, KUAT is the kurtosis. So these are the what you call features of a given signal, and which has been obtained from different signals or different classes. So here we are having binary class, class B and class A. Okay. Now we need to find out how the this data, how they are correlated, if they are correlated, whether they are interrelated with any other features or not, that we need to find out. So for this, what we will do, we will go to the data analysis. In the data analysis, we have to select correlation and then click OK. After this, we have to select the input range. So let's select the input range. We will not include the label because that is not a data. This is just a class label, and we want to find out whether there is a correlation of the different variables of the signals. Okay. So don't forget to click this labels in the front row. We have the labels in the front row, okay, and then we will keep it selected over here, this one, a new worksheet line, or you can put it over here also, and the same sheet also. Click on the output range, click here, and just click somewhere in the cell wherever you want to have the results. Okay, click OK. Now we have got the correlation matrix over here. If you see over here, we are having AM and AM. So since both of them are the same data, so we are getting a highest correlation of 1. Interestingly, if you see the AM and sum, it is also having a correlation of 1. Then also standard deviation and RMS, it is having the sum. It is having a value of 1. So this means the AM and sum, they are highly correlated. Similarly, standard deviation and RMS, they are also highly correlated. Okay. So this is basically cross correlation. When we are talking about two features, this is like sum and AM, this is cross correlation. And when we are talking about AM and AM, or MEDA and MED, which is basically the median and median, so this is autocorrelation, because the same data is being correlated with itself. Hence, it is called autocorrelation. And if you are using two different variables, then it is called cross correlation. Now, as I said, if the two variables, two different variables, they are having a value of 1 or nearly equal to 1, as in this case, standard deviation and variation, from where we are having 0.99, then this means these two variables, I mean the standard deviation and the variable and variance, sorry, and then sum and amplitude modulated value, okay, so these are highly correlated. Now if you see over here, there are certain negative values like minus of 0.901, so this shows that skewness and variance, they are negatively correlated. Okay, they are negatively correlated. They are having a correlation, but that correlation is negatively present. It means, suppose if the variance is increasing, then the skewness, it may decrease. Okay, when we are having 1, that means when AM is increasing, we are having sum which will also increase. But in the negative correlation, if one factor is increasing, then the other factor will decrease. Okay. Now, in this case, what we have done, we have used the values for all the labels, both B and A. Now, let's see what happens if we select only a separate class. Only a single class, not a separate class, sorry. Only a single class. So what happens over there? We will again go to the data analytics correlation, click OK. Now I will select only the labels B, only the values which are related to the B. Here I have selected. Then in the output range, what I will do, I will select this cell, okay, click OK. Now see, even in this one where we have only selected the label B, the correlation in AM and SUM is very high, okay. Similarly, what we can do is that we can do the same analysis for the class A also. For that, what I will do, I will select the filter. Then from this drop down menu, I will only keep A, click OK. But what I will do is that I will copy this and take this data in a new sheet. See, only A labels have been selected. Now what I will do, I will go to again data analysis, correlation, click OK. Let's see, yeah, this whole value is selected. Then my output range will be somewhere over here, click OK. So it says having trouble to offset input reference. Okay, let's see what is the problem. Okay, sorry, somehow this input range, it got changed. So I will just select it again. Okay, then I will select this input range, say K2, click OK. Now we are having, now in this case also we are having summation and AM which are highly correlated, and RMS and STD, they are highly correlated, and due to this reason the correlation in the combined form was also highly correlated over here, you can see, right? Now interestingly, if you see in this Q-ness and RMS, if you see it was previously minus of 0.89, but here it has, the correlation has slightly increased. That means whatever the variation was there, it was mainly due to the A class level. Now let's go and see into the A class level. In the A class level also we can see skewness and RMS, it is having minus of 0.88. so if you see, there is a huge difference and in the correlation between skewness and the RMS of the class A and B, and because of that this combined correlation, it has come down to the minus of 0.89 as compared to the minus of 0.95 when we have used the class B label. I hope you have now understood how to calculate the correlation matrix. Okay, thank you.